Yeah. So if you look at here, an equilateral triangular lamina. See here, when you read the problem, you need to draw some extracts from the problem. One is, what is the lamina here given? Well, that is equilateral triangular lamina. First is taken one extract, right? And it lies or rests, both are same, okay? Lies or rests with one of its edges on HP. So it is resting on HP with one of its edges. These two extracts from this statement. Then, such that the surface of the lamina, such that the surface of the lamina is inclined to HP at 60 degrees. So from this, we can get to know that surface lamina is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees to the HP. So this is one more extract from the problem. Then the edge on which it rests, this is very important. The edge on which it rests is inclined to VP at 60 degrees. It means that here the lamina is inclined to both the planes, but here the edges on which it rests is inclined to VP at 60 degrees. This is one more extract. So from each problem, we need to get to know the extracts from the problem. One is what lamina it is and where it is resting, and the lamina is inclined to which plane, and either it is a lamina is inclined to VP, or edge is inclined to VP, or median is inclined to VP, or apparent median is inclined to VP, or perpendicular bisector is inclined to VP, diagonal is inclined to VP, like that. Many will be there in the problem. So which condition is given, that has to be taken care of. See, in this problem, first is equilateral triangular lamina. While drawing the first position, what we need to know, how to keep the lamina parallel to which plane. I have to keep the lamina. That question you need to question yourself first. Okay. So to which plane I need to keep parallel? To which plane I need to keep parallel? So here, as I told you, as the lamina is inclined to HP at 60 degrees, then you need to keep the lamina parallel to HP only. So that once you get to know, then immediately by keeping the parallel to HP and on HP, all the projection of plane surfaces we are drawing, all the laminas keeping on HP itself. So when the lamina is kept on HP, if you look at here, A, B, C is the triangular lamina is drawn by keeping the edge on the left side here. So you can draw in your own way, convenient way. Okay. So in your convenient way. So we can take the edge on the left side. From now onwards. Okay. So here, after drawing this top view as a true shape, when the lamina is kept parallel to HP, top view will be the true shape. That immediately it has to come to your mind. So you need to draw the top view first with the true shape. After drawing the top view as a true shape, then project these points onto the XY line. Why? Because I have kept the lamina on HP, parallel to HP and on HP. It is placed on the HP. So the front view, whatever you are going to obtain, will be drawn on the XY line. So first statement is satisfied. That is, an equilateral triangular lamina 25 mm side lies with one of its edges on HP. So keeping all the edges on HP, but one edge is kept parallel to perpendicular to the vertical plane, that is AB. Okay, understood? Then the surface, second extract, that is the surface lamina is inclined to HP at 60 degrees. So here, in the second step, while moving from step 1 to step 2, the line view will be taken to start the step 2. Line view will be taken. Accordingly, it has to be rotated. How it has to be rotated? As it is resting on edge, that is VA or AB edge. So that AB edge should come on XY line only, because it is resting on edge only, not on the other edges. That is, BC edge is not resting, AC edge is not resting. So these two edges will come above the HP. Only BA will lie on the HP. So if you look at here, B dash E dash is drawn only on XY line, and remaining BC and AC edges, it has gone above the HP. And this is line, this line view of the triangular lamina is to be rotated, to a given angle, that is 60 degrees with HP. That is 60 degrees with the HP, lamina inclination with the 60 degrees to HP. So this is the HP, below XY line is HP. So with this HP, you need to draw 60 degrees. So after drawing the 60 degrees, one line to be drawn first with the 60 degrees, and take the length B dash C, B dash C dash, here C dash. Take the length of B dash C dash or A dash C dash, then draw an arc, to cut this C dash. C dash is not here, it will come here only. There is a mistake in this. B dash C dash length is not that much. If you just visualize this length and this length is not that equivalent. Okay. So here B dash and this point, this arc is the C dash arc. Okay. So even the front view is also wrong here. So this has to be drawn from this point, Okay. Not from this. Okay. So that you understand. Okay. So here after drawing the second position front view by rotating, by tilting the line view to a given angle, that is 60 degrees, then the top view to be obtained. So how the top view is drawn? By drawing from B dash and A dash, draw vertical projection, so that from A, one horizontal projection, from A dash, one vertical projection, both meet at the point A, Similarly, from B dash, one vertical projection, from B, one horizontal projection, both meet at this particular point B. So that is represented. Then from C dash, you need to draw the projection, vertical projection, and from C, horizontal projection from the previous top view, then obtain the A, B, C, then join A, B, B, C, C, A. Then we can obtain the second position top view. So first set of views is drawn, then second set of views is drawn just by keeping the lamina inclined to only HP. Now third extract, what you got is the edge on which it is rest inclined to VP at 60 degrees. What does it says? The edge on which rest, it means that what edge? There are three edges. One is AB, BA, BC, CA. So the edge on which it rests means what edge it is? It is AB edge only. So AB edge on which it rests means AB edge that is inclined to VP at 60 degrees. So AB edge is drawn, such a way that it is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees to the VP. Above XY line is VP, right? So to the VP, you need to draw a 60 degrees line, 160 degrees line here, 160 degrees line here. Okay, on this 60 degrees line, you need to locate anywhere on this, you need to locate point A. After locating point A, then length of AB is taken. Length of AB is nothing but equal to 25, because this length and this length is not changed. This AB and this AB length is not changed. Got it? So it means that it is equivalent to the 25 only. So A has one, keeping A at one point and draw AB with equal to 25 mm. Then after locating B, you need to get C. But if I am drawing the step 3 views, my reference is what? Step 2 views. Step 2 views. In the step 2 views, BC length is taken. That is, this length is taken from here to here. Okay. And same BC length is taken. I mean, here with the B as the center, BC length as the radius, draw an arc. Okay. Similarly, AC length to be taken, that is A as the center, AC as the radius, draw an arc. So that will get the C point. So join B to C, join A to C, join B to C and join, say for example, A to C and then, sorry, and then C to A, and then C to A. So you need to be drawn B to C and then this triangle to be drawn. So from this same triangle is drawn here. Same triangle is drawn here. So now from after getting this top view, third step three top view, you need to get the front view. How to get the front view? So here just by drawing vertical projection from each vertices, vertical projections from each vertices, that is from A, that is from B, that is from C. So vertical projection is drawn. Now from A, then here from A dash horizontal projection is drawn. From A dash horizontal projection is drawn. So A projection and A dash projection both meet at this particular point. So A dash is located. Similarly, from B, draw vertical projection, and then B dash, draw vertical projection, B dash will be obtained. Means A dash, B dash lie on the XY line only. Why? Because this condition has to be satisfied. Second extract, that is, lies with one of it just on HP. That condition is satisfied here. Okay? So then C projection like this. Then join A dash, B dash, B dash, C dash, and then C dash, A dash. All these points to be joined. This is the step three views. This is how you need to obtain. So what thing to be remember, what are the things to be remembered in this is, first and foremost is, you need to know what type of lamina it is. Is a equilateral triangular lamina or pentagonal lamina or a square lamina. So by reading the problem, these things to be extracted. One is what lamina it is and where it is resting. On HP or VP, then surface of the lamina is inclined to which plane? Surface of the lamina is inclined to which plane? Those extracts are obtained. And then finally, VP. When it comes to VP, VP it may be edge is inclined or median is inclined or appears to be median is inclined, diagonal is inclined. Many conditions will come when it comes to when with respect to the VP. So based on that conditions, you need to proceed the problem. So in this problem, what we start with is, as the lamina is inclined to HP, we kept the lamina parallel to HP first. And the orientation of the triangle is also important. Why? Because the triangle can also be drawn like this. Why can't we, sir? Like this. Yes, you can draw like this also. But when it comes to the second position, see if I draw here, the projection from this point, A dash, and then this point, it is say B dash, say this is A, this is B, C. So if you have drawn like this, what you are going to get here? Like this, okay? So here, this line view in the second position, as it is resting on it, the line view will be rotated like this. See here, here you got in this direction. The orientation of the triangle is like this. In this case, it is like this. So here, these two are correct. So when you use this orientation, then your line view to be rotated about the edge, means in this direction. Not if you draw like this, and then if you draw your line view like this, then it goes wrong. So second step is goes wrong. Got it? So this is very, very important. So the orientation of the triangle can be drawn by keeping the edge on the right side or by keeping the edge on the left side. But if you draw the right side, then rotation should be in this way. Rotation should be in the clockwise direction. Whereas the rotation is in the anti-clockwise direction here. Okay? So that difference you should know. Is it clear? Right. So we'll go to the initial position, of course, you've got to know. Then second position is lamina inclination with HP. That is, line view is rotated to A. Surface lamina, how much is inclined? That has to be rotated. Then third position is VP inclination, which is edge is inclined. Then we have got H is inclined to
VP.
Okay, got it? Right. Next, we'll move to the one more problem. Yeah. So in this problem, you read this once again. What are the extracts can be drawn? One is it's a triangular lamina. Same. Triangular lamina. And rest on what? One of its corners on VP. So in the previous sum it is HP. Now it is on VP. Such that the median passing through the corner on which it rests is inclined 30 degrees to HP and 45 degrees to VP. Here the median is inclined in sense median is also lying in the triangular lamina. Median is also lying in the triangular lamina. It is not a separate part, right? Separate part. So AD1, which lies in the triangular ABC, is nothing but the rectangular lamina is inclined to HP at 30 degrees and inclined to VP at 45 degrees. So when we discuss the PPT here, look at here in the previous. Yeah, here. So when the lamina is inclined to both the planes, then check the resting condition of the lamina. If the lamina is resting on HP, keep the lamina parallel to HP. If the lamina is resting on VP, either it may be edge or it may be a corner, keep the lamina parallel to VP. This is very important. That's what here you got. Here the lamina I told, but it may be a laminar or median or perpendicular bisector or a diagonal, whatever it is. Okay. So when it comes to that, here that median is passing through the corner on which it rests is inclined to HP and as well as parallel to VP. So what the PPT says, when the lamina is inclined to both the planes, then check the resting condition for keeping the parallel to which plane. Okay. So if the lamina is resting on HP, keep lamina parallel. As it is resting on VP, right? Second condition satisfies for this problem. Okay. So in this, lamina is inclined to, both the planes, and it is resting on VP. So when it is resting on VP, keep the lamina parallel to VP. When you keep the lamina parallel to VP, the true shape you are going to obtain in the front view. When the lamina is kept parallel to VP, the true shape we are going to get is in the front view. That is also discussed in the slides. When the lamina is kept parallel to VP, true shape is where you are going to get in the front view. So here the front view is drawn. So here once again I told the orientation of the triangle can be this way or it can be this way also. Both can accepted in the initial position, but be careful while doing in the second position. Why? Because see here, it is the ABC. ABC is drawn by keeping the lamina parallel to VP and projected from A dash to A and then B dash to like this, and then this projection onto the XY line. So you got the top view. So front view I got, top view I got. Okay. Next is lamina is inclined to HP, which will be taken here, HP or VP inclination. Because when the lamina is kept parallel to VP, then you need to incline to VP first to be taken. If the lamina is kept parallel to HP, then HP inclination is taken in the second step. As the lamina is kept in the VP, VP inclination is taken in the second step. So what is the VP inclination here? 45 degrees to VP. So here, this AD1 is equal to AC length here, right? So that has to be rotated, keeping A on XY line. If you look at the previous problem, that is the first problem which we discussed here. So here, see, look at the B dash A dash is lying on the XY line. B dash A dash is lying on XY line. It means that it is resting on edge. Whereas in this problem, in this problem, if you look at A is resting on XY line, it means that the condition is corners resting on corner, resting on corner. So that's why only corner in sense one vertices, corner in sense one vertices. So only one point is on XY line. That is very important. So in this case, if you draw this as the orientation, in the second portion, how it looks like? In the C, the top view will be like, say, for example, like this. Top view is like this, front view is like this. In the second portion I'll draw here itself, okay? The line view should be rotated in this direction. See, it is exactly opposite to this orientation. It is exactly opposite to this orientation. So first step, if you take this way, exactly opposite to this orientation. So these two orientations can be drawn in a different way also, not a problem. But in the second portion, top view in this case, that is line view, second portion line view, to be rotated in this direction, to be rotated in this direction. So find the difference between this way of drawing and this way of drawing. Both are correct. I cannot say that these two are wrong. Both are correct. This is also right and this is also right. People may start like this or people may start like this also. But in the second portion, line view rotation, you should be careful that it has to be rotated about a corner. It has to be rotated about a corner. Is it clear what I'm saying? You see, in this orientation, the corner, about the corner is rotated. In this orientation, this is a corner, means this point. So this point and this point. Okay. Is it clear? Understood what I'm talking about here? Hello? Yeah. Right. So second portion is drawn such a way that AD is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees. Means AD, A dash D1 dash is called true median. A dash D1 dash is called as true median. A dash D dash is called as apparent median. Here, because this A dash D dash is not equal to the A dash D1 dash. Is not equal to the A dash D1 dash. Is it clear what I'm saying here? A dash D dash is not equal to the A dash D1 dash. That's why it is called true length of the median. This is called apparent length of the median. Okay. But here, the median is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to HP. The median is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to HP. So here, when you take the PPT, which we discussed the condition 2, which we discussed the condition 2, okay. See here, condition 2 says what? Median is inclined at an angle of pi. Median is inclined at an angle of pi. So when the median is inclined at an angle of pi, we followed the procedure of drawing first pi line, then locating the true length of the median, that is AD here, A and D on the true inclination line. Then we have taken the AD1 as the radius, A as the center. You have cut the locus of D. You have cut the locus of D. On this AD1 line, you have constructed the triangle of the previous top view. Whereas in this similar fashion in this case, you have to draw first inclination 30 degrees line, 30 degrees line. This is the 30 degrees line. This is the 30 degrees line. On this 30 degrees line, on this 30 degrees line, you locate somewhere A dash. You locate somewhere A dash. And take the length, and take the length A dash D1 dash, and take the length A dash D1 dash, A dash as the center, A dash D1 dash as the radius. Draw an arc to cut this 30 degrees inclination line. So you will get the D1 dash now. So this is called locus of D. This is called locus of D. So once you got the locus of D, then take the apparent length of A dash D dash. Take the apparent length of A dash D dash. Then A dash as the center. Take the A dash D dash as the radius. A dash D dash as the radius. Cut the locus of D. Then you'll get A dash D dash as the one line. Once you got the A dash D dash one line, then you need to reconstruct this triangle of the previous top view, I mean previous front view, should be reconstructed here. So once you got the D, you need to draw a perpendicular. You need to draw a perpendicular like this, to the A dash D dash. Once you draw the perpendicular to the A dash D dash, from D, how much distance is there? So locate the C dash. From D to B dash, how much distance is there? Locate the B dash. And then once you got the B dash and C dash, then join from B dash to A dash. So then join from B dash to A dash like this. And similarly, from A dash to C dash, you need to join. So likewise, you finish the triangle. That is the front view. Once you got the front view, then top view is obtained easily, right? How? By drawing the vertical projection from the front view and horizontal projections from the previous top view. So here, this is the B line. Say, for example, this is the B line. So B line is projected up to this point. B dash line from the previous, front view. Draw vertical projection. Both meet at this point. I'll get B. Similarly, from A, and then from A dash, draw one vertical line. Both will meet at this particular point. So that I'm going to get A. Then C, from C dash, draw vertical projection. Already B and C lies on the same line. So projection is also on the same line. So C dash, you have to draw one vertical projection. Then this intersects. So after getting all the intersection point, join A to C, then join C to B, then join B to A to obtain the top view. So this is the final views. That is step three views. There are three set of views. First set of views, second set of views, then third set of views. This is how you need to draw as per the condition 2. So we have discussed in the PPT condition 2, right? That is when the median is inclined at an angle of pi. But here, median is inclined to VP in this case. Whereas in this case, median is inclined to HP in this case. That's it. Got it? Any doubts in this second problem discussion? So we can move to the next problem. Yeah. So here, this is one more problem where I can discuss a 30 degree, 60 degree square, set square. So here, this is very important. How to draw a set square? With 60 mm longest side. Only thing is here, he has given the 60 mm as the longest side, means this is the longest side, which is 60 mm. So that is to be drawn first. Okay. And of course, before drawing that, why you have to draw the top view as the true shape? That is the first condition, right? So how to know that? That is, can be known that by using condition that what you say? It is resting on side on HP. Making an angle of 30 degrees with the VP. Longest side is making 30 degrees to VP. But the set square itself is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees to HP. So here the lamina is inclined to which plane? Set square is the lamina. Lamina is inclined to which plane here? It is 45 degrees to HP. So lamina is inclined to HP. So keep the lamina parallel to HP. And also it is resting on what? Longest side. So longest side to be drawn either left side or right side. Got it? So he has taken left side. So longest side is drawn left side and then located with AB with length of 60 mm. After getting AB length, then how to draw 30 degrees, 60 degrees set square? So you draw from A, show the 30 degrees inclination. Just extend this line. From like this. We don't know what is the length of AC. But we know the angle of AC. Similarly, we don't know the length of BC. But we know the angle of BC. Angle BC is at an angle of 60 degrees. angle of 60 degrees. Okay, so this can be drawn, this can be drawn like this. So both will intersect at point C. Now erase these two lines. After drawing like this construction, erase these two lines, then project to the xy line to get the front view, to get the front view. So this is the step one is over. For step two, as the lamina is parallel to HP, HP inclination is drawn in the second position. As the lamina is parallel to HP, HP inclination is drawn in the second position. That is, HP is inclined to HP how much? It is 45 degrees. So the line view is rotated. The line view is rotated to an angle of 45 degrees. To an angle of 45 degrees. Clear? So here one more doubt we may get. Why you have taken 30 degrees like this? Why can't be 30 degrees this way? Yes, of course you can draw 30 degrees this side also and 60 degrees this side also. Okay, that is also can be done. So in the second portion, we have rotated to an angle of 45 degrees to HP. So now we have to get the top view. How to get the top view? From the front view, draw vertical projection. So A dash is lies here. From A dash and from A, both intersect at this point. Get the A. Then from A dash, from A, get the intersection point A. Similarly, from C dash, from C dash, then from C, draw from C. This way. So get the intersection point C. Get the intersection point C. So then B, you need to get B dash. So B dash is also lies here. So draw the projection from here, then this is the from B dash, and then from B we need to draw one more line. We'll get the this one. So once you got A and once you got B, once you got C, then join B to C, then join C to, then join C to A, C to A, like this. So we got A to B, B to C, C to A in the top view. So here next position is, as I told you, edge is inclined or lamina is inclined like that. Here in this case is the given that longest side which is resting, that is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to VP. So the same second position top view is rotated by drawing first 30 degrees line, by drawing 30 degrees line like this to certain length. On this 30 degrees line, you take AB as the length. Locate A, and from A to B, draw A to B with a length of 60 mm, locate B also. Once you locate B, take the length of BC of the second portion top view. While drawing the step three views, you need to take the step two views. Reference is step two views. Okay, so take the BC as the length, B as the center, draw an arc like this. Okay, next, AC as the length in the second portion top view, AC as the length, take the A as the center, AC as the radius, draw an arc. So both intersect at this point C. Now AC is joined, now BC is joined. AC is joined, and then BC is joined. So A to C joined, then B to C is joined. So you got the ABC top view. Once you got the top view, how to obtain a front view? You know that, right? Just by drawing the vertical projections from the top view, horizontal projection from the front view. C is here. So from C, draw vertical projection. Then from C dash, draw horizontal projection and get the intersection point C dash. Similarly, from A, draw vertical projection like this. Then horizontal projection, because A dash is the line on the XY line. So draw like this. So both intersect at this point. Then from B, once again you need to draw like this vertical projection till here. Okay. Then from B dash once again here. So locate A dash, locate B dash, locate C dash. So join all these three points. So A dash, C dash, C dash B dash to be joined, C dash B dash to be joined, then from A dash, then B dash is to be joined. Like that, we can finish the front view. Any doubts? Any doubts in this problem? Hello, are you there? I got the screenshot.
Illa sir.
Illa.
Illa sir. Screen ekanna sir.
Bande aur nimsha matte screen ayyo. Orli bidina.